number of sunshine hours in Egypt is 3 times greater than in Germany. And the sunshine in Egypt is more intense. It is just a few months since Cairo was the scene of a revolution. Government and party buildings were torched during anti-government protests. Though the political situation remains unstable, Egypt is included in the planning of Desertec. Aglaia Wieland is director of strategy for the Desertec Industrial Initiative, or DII. Most members of the consortium were represented at its conference in Cairo.
That is extremely important and very convenient, having a large number of business partners in one spot at the same time. Otherwise, you have to travel from one meeting to the other, all over the world. It doesn't always look like it, but the people have time here. We're here for 2 days to exchange ideas. We can really sink our teeth into issues, so it's valuable time.
Wieland is developing a strategy for the next 4 decades. The plan is that by the year 2050, Desertec will supply 15% of Europe's electricity. To make that a reality, many countries and companies will have to cooperate. While Aglaia Wieland is networking in the lobby, DII's chief executive, Paul van Son, is attending the session in the main conference room.
Interest is growing in Northern Africa and is set to grow even more. The people there are realizing that the future lies in renewable energy.
After 2 days in windowless conference rooms, it's time to go out into the sun.
We're going to visit a hybrid power plant at Kuramat.
With a police escort for the 100-kilometer trip through the desert. At Kuramat, arrays of mirrors cover an area of 130,000 square meters. The rays of the sun are reflected onto a pipe and heat the fluid inside to about 400 degrees Celsius. The fluid then heats water until it boils. The steam drives turbines that generate electricity. What's special about the power plant, built mainly by Spanish and German firms, is that it also operates at night.
It was a new idea to integrate solar-generated heat into a gas-fired power plant. It makes the whole thing cheaper. The challenge was to make it work.
So during the day, electricity is generated by the sun. At night, it's generated by gas. Desert sand blows onto the shiny surfaces of the solar panels and reduces their efficiency, so they have to be cleaned every 2 days. Experiments in solar energy were conducted here before the First World War, but the technology has only really taken off in recent years.
It never ceases to impress me. Out here in the real desert in Egypt, you can see how well it can be done, how well structured and implemented, and that it really works.
The hybrid power plant was not originally meant to be part of Desertec, but now the idea is to hook it up to a grid spanning northern Africa, so that eventually electricity can flow to Europe. Back in Cairo, there is little time for the conference participants to see the sights. But there is time for a stroll.
It's a very lively city and very noisy, vibrant and dynamic.
This is Tahrir Square, where thousands demonstrated earlier this year against President Hosni Mubarak. Despite the political change sweeping the region, Desertec is counting on Egypt, Morocco, and Tunisia to remain in the project. The costs for the power plants and the grid are hard to estimate. There is talk of 400 billion euros.
We're not talking about one big project that will take 40 years, but about lots and lots of smaller projects. We'll see what they amount to at the end of the day, who will get involved, and how much private investors will contribute. Ask me again in 2051.
Although the price and the scale of the project are hard to compute, decisions are being made that are set to transform the future power supplies to much of Europe and Northern Africa.